Welcome to Mudding with Beags. This is episode 44. Hope you guys are doing good tonight. And I figured we'd go take a look at a little something I found this week. I thought it was kind of interesting. It reminded me of when they took down the towers and hauled off all the debris to China.
I'm just coming back down from the fort heading towards town, but before I do that, I just want to show you this over here. You've no idea what you're looking at, have you? See where all those cars are parked? That is actually part of San Francisco, which I better explain, hadn't I? That's all reclaimed land, and it was reclaimed with ballast from the ships which came from San Francisco, and they dumped the ballast there before they picked up the coal. Why was there so much ballast in San Francisco? Well, it was all from the 1906 San Francisco earthquake. So that is really a little piece of Height Ashbury. Love and peace. Right, let's head on. Some of us never really left the 60s.
Kind of interesting, huh? And this weekend, I got a new t-shirt in. And this one's a Flat Earth Asterix. And there's the front, pretty cool. And this one's blue, but you can get all different colors. I also got mugs and posters and hoodies. I appreciate all the support you guys have given. And I am starting to do live streams now. And so leave a comment in the description of any topics you'd like me to cover, and maybe I'll get to them. And I've already gotten a few ideas of things to talk about from the comments in the live chat, and I think we'll go and look at some of those things. But I look forward to a good 2022. So Beagle, roll them credits. Let's go Muddin. '90s New Zealand grocery shop interior. You know, it's interesting how the old shops, how everything was so stacked when they presented things. So look at the stacking. They were like crazy about stacking. Oh, gas lamps, or oil lamps, excuse me. Stacking. Freaky kid. I don't know, they're just always stacking. I don't know. It's a hell of a way to display. It's a weird skylight there. Anywho, got 1903 Oriental Hotel Boardwalk, Manhattan Beach, Brooklyn, New York. Boss man out for a walk. These old lights. I think these were at one time Antiquitec lights, ether lights, but then they converted them. They're too damn nice. I don't know. Guess we'll never know.
you up to, law dog? He's probably like, you're not allowed to walk on this beach. You must respect my authority. Ether fencing, ether finial, finial, finial. Bringing in the juice. Ether finial fencing, finial. Ether fencing, finial, 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 finial. This thing's got a lot of power. Ether fencing. Horseshit. Fire escape. We added that. Look at these right here. Some kind of windows, but I don't know. These look like windows, but these look like they're closed off. Or these windows with shutters on them or something. I don't know. Hard to tell. Boy, he's taking a big old pee. Good for you. Hoorah. Let's see. Horseshit awnings, of course. 1905 arch. Macy and Company, New York. So Macy's. This is the original Macy's. Some BS statue there. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. In case you were unaware and uninformed, now you're aware and informed. And that is pavement light. So is that. In case you weren't aware of that. Pavement light is cover up. There's more pavement light for the mudflood. More pavement light. There's Wilma. That is Fred's lady friend. There is more pavement light, more pavement light, ladies in uniform, man in uniform, more pavement light, 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 and on and on and on and on and on and on and on. Where is the pavement light today? Well, they took it out. They took it out. It didn't work. It was a bad idea. I mean, it did what they wanted it to do, but it failed. It broke. It leaked. So it failed. It sucked. If things don't, you know, perform right, they've got to do something different. This one was probably part of the wind catcher system. See how it opens up. Wind catcher system is a system that would allow air to flow through the buildings and bring in fresh air and more regulate the temperature. Not like air conditioning. Turkish trophies. Okay. That's weird. Scrub cartouche. Looks like R.H. Macy stamped his name right on the front there. Old Ethelites. Something going on that cartouche. Looks like got the Macy star. Which came first, Macy or the star? That's an interesting question. Look at that. Did you get the star from the building? Is that where he came up with the idea for the logo? That's an interesting thought. You have to question these things. I mean, it's very possible that Macy, you know, came on and he claimed this building, and when he claimed this building had stars on there, I don't know if they're red, but it doesn't seem like they would have been red, but then he painted them red and claimed them as his logo. Why not? Truth is simple. There's an owl representing Tartaria. Looks like another one right there. Some kind of statue I can't see. Check out that etherolite. Ginormous. Old trolleys. Boater hats. Boater hats history is interesting. If you want an interesting little rabbit hole to go down. Anywho, we got 1906 shaft number 2, Quincy Copper Mine, Hancock, Michigan. I don't know. This there's Fred and Wilbur's Fred's cousin, and they get the, you know, building American then. Look how big that door is. There's our door. Old train. That's a proper foundation right there. This is a strange structure. This is odd too. I'm not sure what's going on there. They're transferring bins of copper up this contraption here. I don't know. That's how they would hoist things up to the upper levels. I put a pulley on that, hoist it up. There's no wheel. That's old school. Anyways, it's kind of weird. 1907 Northampton, Massachusetts, Draper Hotel. There's Fred, Fred's the Horse Build America. We got ventilation in the underground right there, there, there. There. Might have a drop in Winders below ground right there behind that wrought iron. There's something going on right there. Same here. Ah, barbershop below ground. Ah, who'd have thunk it? Why would you put a barbershop below ground? Down in the dark where you can't see. I mean, that just makes no sense to me. Crazy. Beer. Horseshit awnings. Arc light. Flora Lee representing the Taurus and flat earth. Look at that intricate brickwork there. So unnecessary. Completely unnecessary. See, it's all facade, see? The brick building was facade. I-870. Florida Lee. What does that say? Eighth block or bitch block? Fitch block. Hell, I don't know. Weird. Ether antenna. Finch block. It's an F. Okay. That's funny. There's something going there. Let's see. Let's see. Drugs, medicine, chemicals. Okay. Got 1908 Spalding Hotel, Duluth, Minnesota, next door to the more intimate Hotel Windsor. Okay. Fitger's beer. We got a deal going down here. These boys up no good. That's Boss Man right there. In case you're wondering about Boss Man. Let's get up here and look at this. Okay, look at, we got some winders below ground level here. See that? More there. There's Fred, Fred's Horse Builds America. In case you didn't know, arc light. I believe fire hydrants are old world. And I believe Campbell did a video on the old fire truck steam engines, and I think they're old world as well. So I agree with you there, definitely. Ether antenna. That's Moorish looking right there, Ether antenna. The building has a Moorish look. And that's because the Moors were in America. Arched windows. More arched windows. Okie dokie. Got 1909 Union Station, Portland, Maine. Demolished in 1961. They took until 1961 to get rid of this piece of shit. Unbelievable. Why in the world would they have not demolished it in 1910? I mean, they should have known within 1 year that this was such a piece of crap that it had to go. I mean, something's wrong here. I mean, it even had fountains. Seriously? Why would you have fountains? I mean, they're part of the free energy system. They should have got rid of that. That way it wouldn't have been known to us. Look at those things. What in the world? That looks techie. I don't know. That's a weirdness back here. There's Fred way back in the back doing some work. Fred's a horse built America. Clean back in the background. Makes you wonder. Woman in uniform. Ether finials on the top. Right there too. That looks suspect. See that those lines right there? That looks suspect to be Photoshop to me. But it's just suspect. I can't say for sure. Not on this one. Big ol' arch doorway. Beautiful stone. Clocks are expensive. I mean, I know it sounds simple to say clocks are expensive, but I mean, they were. Back then, clocks that like this, these big-ass clocks were a big deal. You didn't just make a clock. You didn't just throw one out. I mean, they were hard to make. They were expensive to make. So why would you see them all over the place? Who's got all this money to be throwing up? Look at that ether finial. That's sucking up some juice. Check that out. Wow. I believe we added the gutters. Okay, interesting. We got 1937 Charleston, South Carolina, Old Armory, 8 Chalmers Street. Original structure dates to 1851. And see, it's covered on the front, facaded, and it's a brick building. So it's a trick of the eye. And I can make a case that this is a flat earth asterisk. You just double it on the bottom. See the bricks underneath? And there's the three door thing we've noticed a lot. Where they had two smaller doors on the side of a really big door. I think there's something to that. I-872. Oh, hello. What we got here? What you got there? What's that mean? This is what Old Armory... They always love to call armor, say the armories are castles, you know, that when it's an armory, it's a castle, I've noticed. Why did they make them castles? I've had a lot of problems with this one. It's cracking there. That's an interesting symbology there. That's a flat earth asterisk. Augusta, Georgia, 1903. Albion Hotel and Confederate Monument. There's Fred and Wilbur. Fred and Wilbur are the horses that built America. In case you weren't aware of that. Creepy kid. Shoe Company. Ventilation to the underground right there. Right there. More ventilation. Boss man. Let's see. Looks like the law right there. Big old arch windows. Scrub cartouche there, it looks like. Got some crosses there. Flat earth asterisks right there. Arched windows. Why would you build your windows in the hardest way possible? You wouldn't. Scrub cartouche. Just because you can do something doesn't mean you did it. Notice how these old obelisks, they always seem to have on the four corners lights. This one has the lights removed, but it had lights at one time, I bet. They had some sort of ether lights on each corner, which means if they're on all of them, it tells me that they were there for a specific reason. These are horseshit statues we added. We probably added this mess here too. That's a big obelisk. We probably added this little dude here, took the top off of it, and then called it a Confederate monument. And now they're taking them down because they're too stupid to realize what they are. They probably know that we're figuring out what they've done and that these things are still functional. They're trying to get rid of them. We got Boston circa 1906, Maverick Square, and tunnel entrance. This tunnel entrance. There's Fred's Horse Built America. He's usually around somewhere. East Boston. Boss man right there. Big old arched windows right here. They've bricked in. I think this is the technology here, the coins. Arched windows all over the place. And it's brick. Everything's brick at their antenna. Maverick House. And there's another clock. Who's making all these clocks? Who's funding all these clocks? I don't know. Moving on.
Got Boston 1906 Mechanics Hall.
Huntington Avenue demolished in 1959 to make way for Prudential Center. Well, good. I'm sure that Prudential Center looks much better than this piece of crap. No doubt. I think we probably should go insert that picture here so we can see that better looking building, because it's probably much better than this thing with mudflood windows, arch windows everywhere, arch doors, stairs going up because the doors are above ground. Shouldn't be big high doors, mudflood windows, ivy. Huh. Big door. Zip it, skip it. Hey, we ain't got time for that. We trying to do some mud flooding. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. There's Boss Man. In case you're wondering about him. Check out all these arch windows. Ether antenna, ether antenna. See, this is our technology here. This is what we came up with, ladders. We can handle a ladder. Ether fencing, ether antenna, ether finial. School of Gymnastics. Normal school. That's weird. Is there an abnormal school? Arc light. Old ether lights here. Anywho, I think that's about the gist of this one. We got Cincinnati, 1912 Main Street from Fountain Square with a nice view of the Blamer Building. Okay. Whatever you say. Man and woman in uniform. Right out of Central Casting. So she, I mean, she's right off a movie set. She's off right off of Disney's movie set right there. Perfect. The perfect outfit. Same with this guy. Perfect. Some symbology there. Big old Mudflood entrance right there. That's going into the underground there, I bet. Tours Field. Ether antenna. Ether finial. Ether finial. Look at that facading. It's a brick building with facade. Anytime you see where it looks like stone, it's facaded. Or concrete or stucco or whatever. So they're all brick. A coal hole cover there, there, and there. Trap door into the underground there. There's pavement light right there and there. Possibly pavement light right there. Hard tail. Arc light. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. There's Boss Man. Penis Cat Boss Man. You must respect my authority. Paints. Toys. I like reading the signs. You never know what you can learn by reading the signs. Big old arches. Taurus is right there. There's probably a wind catcher that's been modified. Ether antenna. I wonder why they didn't use the wind catchers. I haven't figured that one out yet. Porthole. Another porthole. And you got a air conditioning system, you know, a system that, I mean, I know that, I think the climate had changed. It's probably the reason, but it's just weird. Seems like they would have still used it, I don't know, to get fresh air, because I know they had trouble with fresh air into the buildings later on. Circa 1900 barge, New York office. Boss Man. Fred's on job with Wilbur. Lunch wagon. That's their finial. That's their antenna. That's probably a wind catcher that's been modified. There's a porthole. That would be part of the wind catcher system. There'll be a GIF in the end of the video explaining what a wind catcher is. In case you're confused. Or new or whatever. Want to learn. We got 1900 St. Paul Episcopal Cathedral, Buffalo, New York. Got obelisk all over the front here. Pooper Scooper Man's bucket. And there. No, that's not him. I don't see Pooper Scooper Man. Boss Man. Fire Hunter's Old World. Arc Light. Underground right there. Fred's the horse that built America. Arches. There's Flat Earth Asterix. Flat Earth Asterix is the symbol that represents the flat earth that we live on. Ether antenna. These are tech. Smokestacks that aren't smokestacks. Don't know what they were. We used them as smokestacks. We're kind of not very intelligent compared to the people that built this world. Sorry. Facts is facts. Etherfenium. There's portholes there. This could be a wind catching system here. They have many different kinds of wind catchers, so it's possible. This thing is really cool. Diamond symbology. I have wondered if the diamonds represent the unity of the civilizations. I don't know. Just a thought. It's a weird thing. Ether antenna up there, ether antenna there. Big arches. This building has probably been faceted with that galvanized metal, in my guess. Diamond symbology. There's something going on right here. That's pavement light right there on the bottom. Right there too. You see it's going down at an angle. Check out those Ether lights. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. Bicycles repaired. I bet you were pretty wealthy if you ran a bike shop back then. Old World Fire Hydrant. Boss Man right there. There's Pooper Scooper Man's bucket. There's Pooper Scooper Man. Guess you're Pooper Scooper Man follower. We got another one here. I don't know where he is. They must walk pretty far. I don't know. Anyways. 1904, Philadelphia, Bruce. I know I just butchered that. 4th and Ramstead Streets. Okay. Looks like a grate going, showing the windows underground. And we got door underground, windows underground. Got Fred right here, and that's Wilma. She's checking out Fred's hind end. Wilma likes to get a little freaky here and there. Can't blame her though. Gal got to get her freak on every now and then. Got windows below ground, doors below ground, porthole there. Something there, hard to tell. These right here are probably those. I'm out of brain fart. Those doors to get into the underground. I forget what they're called. You know what I'm talking about. I've said it enough times. Let's see. That's interesting. Weird, but interesting. Got a lot of brick here. Diamond symbology. The diamond was an important symbol. As above, so below, diamond. And then see this running in unison. Like it's, they're working together. Horse field, big old portholes. Man, that's really cool. Look how techy that looks. Venetian wave. Ether antenna. I'm not sure what this is. Could be a maybe a radio tower. I'm not sure. Might be too early for radio towers. I'm not sure about that. Not sure about that. There's that weird word, Barose. I hope I didn't butcher it. If I butchered it, I'm sorry. I'm not a wordsmith. Never have been. There's a big door. I think we've added these stairs. Arc light right here. That's weird right there. Four floors. Get your whole floor. All right. $19.05. Waukesha Hotel and Rector Bathhouse, Hot Springs, Arkansas. Rector Bathhouse. Now, that leaves something to be desired in the naming. Just saying. I think I'd have come up with a better name than that. I don't want no bathhouse to be calling no. I'm going down to Rector to get my butt washed. I'm going to have to pay up, pass on that one. Boss man. Could be a ventilation underground right there. Right there, there. Got a barber pole. I don't know where the barber shop is. Maybe this is the barber shop. I don't see an underground. These could be underground vents, but it's hard to tell. They probably aren't. Old shoeshine stand at the finial. At the finial, Rector, lower leaf of control, at their antenna, okie dokie, not seeing too much there. We got 1910 New Orleans, Louisiana. N.O. and Mississippi River from Hotel Grundwald. So we got us a panoramic shot here. Let's see what we got. 1910. Got this going on. That is incredible. Onion Dome. Ether antenna right there. Smokestacks and ain't smokestacks. That's interesting back there. Onion Dome. Not the clearest picture in the world. Get up this larger resolution. There's some of those stands for the Mardi Gras parade, which are interesting. Check out that. Big old smokestacks and ain't smokestacks. Wonder what they used them for. Arched windows everywhere. Diamond symbology there. A cupola. Wow, look at that one. That's impressive. Portholes. Onion Dome cupola. Healing center. Another healing center. Ether antenna. Another healing center. They must have had some really healthy people back then. Back in the old world. Alright. That's about it for that one. Cleaning snow from New York streets in 1908. This is a group of the street cleaners. These are the guys I call the pooper scooper men. They wear these little uniforms in the winter, little white uniforms. They got pavement light right here. Boss man right there. Kitchen underground right there. And right there. Clocks are expensive. Old world light. Old world light. Okay. Got a Coliseum, Chicago. Don't know what year. That's interesting coding. It could be pavement light right there. It's hard to tell though. Could be here too. I'm not willing to say it is, but it could be. That underground right there. At their antennas. Eagle right here. Representing the Phoenix. And Mercury. Venetian shell. We're taking a break here. Look at this horseshit ladder. Oh my gosh. Nope. I'm not climbing that. Nope. No, 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 no. Nope. That's the technology we have right there. When people say that we built this, well, they're saying we built it with this technology. Yeah. I don't think so. That's super sketchy. Probably a wind catcher system here. This opening window. Alright. Alright, moving on. Got 1923. Donnelly Cadillac Agency. Corner of Van Nuys and O'Farrell. That's pretty. Well, I bet that cost a penny. Hmm. Huh. A little kitty. There she is. Scrub cartouche. I think these are tech. Little kitty. Windows at ground level. That's odd. Cartouche with a coat of arms. Interesting. Looks like a tourist field there. Alright. Got Detroit circa 1908. Detroit City Gas Company built Washington Boulevard and Clifford Street. There's Fred. He's the Horse Built America, in case you didn't know. Electric car. Got a underground trapdoor here with pavement light in it. Yep. So these are probably pavement light up here, just can't see it. Boss man. Big ass door. Water wagon. scrub cartouches all the way across. Scrub cartouche. All the way down. Lateraline. Arc light. It's got a coat of arms. That's interesting. Phoenician shells up here. Eternal flame, maybe? That's impressive right there. 1908. Yeah, we came in and put the awnings on these buildings. That's what we did. Phoenician shells. I wonder how many people actually knew what was going on. E.T. Barnum. Huh. Park building. At their antenna. Alrighty. Detroit, 1910. Knights of Maccabees. Woodward Avenue. And Mudflood windows there. More over here on this building. Yeah, we can tell we put that horse shit on there. Ivy. Mudflood windows back there. Maybe a Phoenician shell, hard to tell. Tours field. Little flower pyramid symbol. Ether fencing. Ether finial up here. And we got Detroit, 1912. Elliot Taylor and Wolfenden Company. Probably butchered that. Millinery department. Millinery department. Hell, who's writing these words? That's where they get the hats. Just say they get the hats here. You wonder where the big hats from? They came from the big hat store. So this is central casting, I guess. Okay, we got edge of Burn District, corner of Franklin and Sacramento Streets, San Francisco, aftermath of the 1906 earthquake and fire, otherwise known as the Dew Attack. That's Freddy's, the horse that built America. I guess he's the horse that cleaned up the Dew Attack. Ether fencing, more ether fencing. Arched windows, at their fencing. I think it's interesting your windows are still intact. I would think you'd have more windows broken out from earthquake. You can tell that sucker goes down in the ground. Look at that right there. Yep, I bet it goes down in the ground at least one level. We see you. We know what you're up to. At the fencing. As always, the link for the pictures will be in the description. You can go do your own looking. At their finial there. So that chimney crumbled. That wasn't a chimney. There's some windows below ground. So that house goes down into the ground. At the fencing. Here too. I was thinking it's interesting how the buildings fall and then the chimneys stand. That's interesting. Anywho. February 1930, Washington, D.C. Army airship C-41 lands on the mall. Okay. How much mud do you think's here? One, level two, level three, level four. What's that? That's weird. Little markings there. I don't know what I got in the tanks. They got guys sticking out the window. I'm not so sure I want to get up in one of them things. I don't know. Well. We got Floral Fate with Dirigible, Pasadena, California. I don't know what that Floral Fate, I don't know what that means. With the Dirigible. Just a weird picture. They were important back then. Florida 1894 Hotel Royal, Ponciana, Palm Beach Railroad Magnet, Henry Flagler's giant wood frame hotel, which at the time was the largest built or largest building in Florida. And this picture doesn't do it justice, but this building is huge. Absolutely huge. Probably a wind catcher there. Tourist fields. Just astronomically huge. Ladder lean at their antenna. I don't know. That's a lot of hotel for, you know, 1894. Gulfport, Mississippi, 1906. Powerhouse is a great southern hotel. Arched windows. Interesting kind too. That's weird. What's that supposed to be? I don't even know. That's odd. Got weirdness on the foundation there. What they're calling the foundation. At least. I would imagine we added this smokestack. That doesn't look old world. This could be a wind catcher. Could have a water tank in it too. Ding. Let's see. Porthole has been removed. Okay. Got 1943 Chicago, Illinois Union Station train concourse. What's interesting about this is it's the whole floor is pavement light, as you'll see here. All pavement light. Flat Earth asterisk. Waiting rooms. For us bonds. Oh yeah. Don't just spend that money. Pay for the wars. We're going to start wars and then you pay for them. Brilliant. I mean, these elitists, they sure are brilliant. I mean, they really are. They have had us fooled to do their bidding for so long. And we just put up with it. 1923 Water Conduit. Part of the Washington, D.C. aqueduct system. Kind of interesting. Bringing in the concrete. Laying down with a mold. Looks like boss man in there. Some sort of steam engine there. Maybe a steam shovel. It's kind of weird. New York, 1908. 23rd Street East from 6th Avenue. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. In case you didn't know. So that might be some coal hover covers there. Got stairs going to the underground. Zip it, Skippy. Stairs in the underground right there. Hush. They don't want to hear you. Eden must see. Interesting. Third rail trolley system. So it's either with a cable or an electrical conduit going on that third rail. Interesting. Ether antennas. Pavement light right here. Ventilation underground right here. Pavement light all the way up here. All the way up. These are probably ventilation grates. Arc light. That's pretty. I don't know what that represents, but it's pretty. Very nice. Four holes here for the wind catcher system. Urns. More arch windows. These are prism glass here in the transoms. This piece from here to here is called a transom. And a lot of these are being found today when they're buying the businesses and uncovering them. Because they were covered up for a long time. People didn't need them. They shoot light back into the building. Same thing as the pavement light. Clocks are expensive. Big ol' arches there. Big ol' arch there. How big that one is. Alright, New York, circa 1912, Grand Union Hotel, 42nd Street, Park Avenue. Third rail system. Men and women uniform, boater hat uniforms. Fred's the horse that built America. Might have some underground here. You got a barber pole. It's always a red flag for underground. There's a trap door. That's an underground. Like much of an underground right there. All is just covered up now. Underground right there and there. Yep, they covered all that up. Arc light. Loft man. There's pooper scooper man's bucket. This trolley's coming out from the underground here. Interesting. I think we added the fire escapes. Poor hole. Ether antenna. Ether fencing, ether antenna. Poor hole. Another poor holes. These are part of the wind catchers here. These aren't poor holes, sorry, but they are part of the wind catcher. Had to do with adjustments. How much airflow was going in and out. That's our antenna. Manhattan Stores Warehouse Company. Alright. Got the fence in there. Looks like an elevated train. An L. Alright. Nippon Club, New York, 1915. That looks like a Phoenician lady. Interesting. What they got going there? That's odd. Yeah, wind is below ground. Oh, look at that. Medusa? Huh. Interesting. Taurus field. Eagle. Representing the Phoenix and Mercury. Interesting heads. That's a big door. Door's way too big for us. Way too big. A lot of flowers. Urns. This stained glass Phoenician show. Flower. Unscrubbed cartouche. You can still find some. Windows on ground level. Big ass door. Unscrubbed cartouche. Phoenician show. Flat Earth asterisk. That's weird. Phoenician show. That's so pretty. Looks like a star fort there. Yep. And there too. Huh. Interesting picture. Port Huron, Michigan, 1900. General view east from post office. Arched windows. These little arches here. Wonder if they changed something here. That's weird. Arches. Arches. Fred's a horse to build America. Looks like pavement light there. Got an entrance to the underground here. Coal hole covered there, coal hole covered there. It could be pavement light right there, there, and there. Hard to tell though. It's possible. Good old Fred. That's boss man. We added the steps. At the fencing there. You know, it's easy to tell what we built. We built that, you know. It's easy to tell. Arched windows. Not the clearest picture in the world. Hard to tell what's going on. See us first. Shoes. Seen a lot of pictures where children didn't have shoes back then. Old tall ship. There's two. They didn't have shoes, and it seemed like shoes were hard to get. I don't know, I've seen some weird shoe pictures. Okay, Rife Snyder Balloon Shop. Scrater? I don't know what the hell they're saying. Maybe it says it on here and you can read it. I don't know. This is some weird stuff. I don't know what this is. Some sort of balloon stuff. I have no idea. Just thought I'd share it because I found it and it was weird. A lot of people like to look into dirigible stuff. Got a view from 33rd floor of the Met Building, Northeast New York, 1908. Portholes there. Got a staircase going up, spiral staircase. Maybe this is one of those docking stations for the dirigibles. Maybe that's a wind catcher there. Check out that finial. Wow. I don't know if they docked the airships up there. I find it hard to believe that they could control the airships so they could dock them, but I mean, I don't know. Interested underground here. Trap door there. That's something there for the underground. Coal hole there. Chimney is not a chimney. Part of the wind catcher system. Got an entrance to the subway here, underground here. Possibly have pavement light right here, along here, with these raised platforms. They like to do that. Put them in raised platforms and level them out. Probably got a drop in right here. Probably got the same platform, pavement light right here. Hard to say. It's just, from my research, that's what that is. Can't prove it. Check out that castle. That is a full-fledged castle with a wind catcher. That thing is huge. Big old dome. This image is really degraded. But it's still cool. Got a bridge in the background being built. Not sure which one. One of them New Yorkers will tell us. I don't know how people live like this with people all on top of them. I couldn't do it. It's too much. Alrighty. We got Vintage Streets of St. Louis, Missouri, 1900. That's a coal hole cover. That's possibly a coal hole cover. Not sure though. There's another coal hole cover. That's pavement light. Those are called bullseyes. Trap door into the underground. Boss man. Fred's on the job. Getting the horsing done. Creepy eyes. Yep, creepy eyes. Check out that spiral staircase on the outside of the building. That's sketchy. I don't know about that. Porthole. Lions. Tartarian lions. I think old Snake Man worked on this building. I think he told me that. I think he told me there was pavement light in this building too. He might come in the chat tonight. Alrighty. Washington, D.C., 1917, Shoreham Hotel, 15th and H Streets, Northwest. The smorgasbord of architectural styles was demolished in 1929. Oh, that's awesome. I love it when they get down to demolishing them. Saves me the trouble having to look at them anymore. I love it. Yeah, boss man. Underground. More underground. We added the stairs. We added this horse shit. If it looks like horse shit, we probably did that. Mr. Contractor was called in, and Mr. Contractor does good horse shit. Top best horse shit in the business. That's venial. At their antenna. That's pretty cool right there. Look at that brickwork. Give me a blueprint for that, Mr. Contractor. Yep, I'd like to see that porthole. Yep, I definitely would like to see that. Windows at ground level or windows. Alrighty. And we got construction on the north middle tower and drone of the varied industries, dome of the varied industries building for the Louisiana Purchase Exposition in 1904. And I wanted to put this one in here because it is definitely photoshopped. No question. If you look around the right here, it's that dark area there, and 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 there, over here. Oh, that's been taken out. They've gone in here and taken all that out. Now I'm finding more and more of these doctored photos from the construction photos of the Louisiana Exposition. So I might have to just do a video just on those at some time, because see, this is the original right here. Now I'm not saying why they doctored it. You can see it's doctored here and here. You see it's doctored. Okay. Now I'm not saying that, you know, what the reasoning is for doctoring this photograph. I don't know the reason. You know, it could be simple. Could be that they wanted that it was overexposed and or underexposed, whatever. And they wanted it to be lighter, and so they did this in order to bring it about. But either way, it's doctored, and so now we have to question these photos. They're not true. And that's proof. It's Biggs out.
Of the light of that cold, dry land. Never mind who held you last night. Come and take my, come and take my hand. I will find you in the black light.
Again.
I've got one that can see.
Welcome to the underground.
This is my kung fu, and it is strong.
See you later.